Hey there, how's it going? I'm Eric, and this is my third year doing Extra Life. I'm so excited to be doing it once again and raising money for Johns Hopkins University. They saved my oldest daughter's life twice, and through an affiliated hospital, they saved my youngest children's lives when they had to be in a NICU from being born premature. This year, I've got lots of great incentives that I hope will inspire you to donate money to my Extra Life campaign. First of all, this year, I'm going to be matching donations for the first $100. So for every dollar you put in, I'll also put in a dollar. In addition to that, for every dollar you donate, I'm gonna be doing sit-ups or push-ups, one sit-up per dollar. So if you really wanna make me suffer, donate lots and lots of money and I'll have to do lots and lots of push-ups. Last year, Dan donated $100 and I had to do 100 push-ups and boy, was I winded at the end of that. This year, I've got a goal of $500 and I'd really, really like to reach it. This is way more than I've ever tried for, but it's really important to me because it really helps a lot. It helps provide lots and lots of healthcare for kids that can't afford it and for families that really need it. If we do reach $500, then I'll be coming up with some stretch goals that we can do and see if we can get to 1,000. That would be mind-blowing, but if we could do it, think of all the lives you could be helping. Thanks a lot, and enjoy this game. Bye. It's time for EveryPlay's Human Resource Machine, Episode 5. Oops, there we go, there I am. Hey guys, how's it going? Let's get this game started up. Since this starts up very quickly, I figured it's better to not start it up so that it won't conflict with the audio of the appeal video. this has been a pretty amazing barbecue weekend for me, or week. Made barbecue for my employees yesterday. 6 racks of ribs and a whole bunch of chicken. And then last night through today, I made some brisket, just had it for lunch. It was amazing. It was really good. Way better than my first time. Still some room for improvement, but pretty good. Pretty good, I would say. I'm also getting over a cold, unfortunately. All right, let's see here. Ah, the Fibonacci's. Right. Alright, so the issue I was having here last time was that keeping things sorted in terms of which numbers I was adding together. I could probably try and continue from this one, but let's do a copy paste and see what happens. All right, so let's just run through it. So I start off with a 1 and a 1, because that's always the Fibonacci sequence. I grab that, put it there. Grab that, add it to that. All right. Grab that, add it to that. Compare. So far, so good. Then I grab that and add it to that. That's not what I should have done. Alright. So. Let's see here. Alright, so my jump of negative, I'm going to leave a note here. Where am I? Oh, I need to stop. Okay. This is my compare point to make sure I'm still below the number I need to be below. When I get here, alright, so
I start off okay. Then I want to copy. From 7. And edit to 8. So if it's 1 and 2, I think I have to ping pong if I want this to work. Because which place holds the biggest number is always going to change, I guess. Unless I'm missing something really easy. Copy from 7. So now 7 has the bigger number. I think the problem is seven. Let's see. All right, so 1, 1. And I put 2 here. 2, 1. I put 3 here. See, that's not right. Here. 5 and 4 is 9. Wait, 8. 5 and 3. 8. Alright, so I think together. So I always want the biggest one to be in 7. What if I then copy 7 to 8? Maybe that'll work. Let's see. Nope. I think I even got further along last time. Alright, let's step through it. Yeah, I don't want to do that, do I? Okay, so let's try again. So I've got 2. I want to add it to 1, but I want to put it in 8. So maybe instead of jumping, want to copy from 7 and to 8. Copy to 8. No, This is getting too complicated. Frustrating. I feel like this should be simpler. Maybe if I start again from scratch. Zero. Bump. No. Oops. Copy to... Let's do it up here. Copy to one. Bump one. Bump from one. Copy to two. Copy to zero. Gotcha. Now. I want to copy from one. Edit. To two. Here. I want to subtract zero. It's negative. Then copy from I think that's one thing I want to do is I want to copy it also to 4. 4 is going to hold it just in case I need to go back and forth on this stuff. It's always going to be in 4. Okay. So copy to 4, copy from 4, unbox it. Okay. So inside here, if it's not negative, copy from 4, oops, copy from 4, box it, okay, alright, so now it's at 1, okay, so now, copy from 1 add to 2. Copy to 2. Copy to 4. Sub 0. Negative. Same place. All right. Up somewhere, but I want to jump back to the beginning. No, not that far. Maybe here? Let's see what happens. 1, 1, 1, 1, 2. I screwed up here somewhere. Let's get rid of all these jumps. Too far. Bring all that back. Got confused without my jumps. Thank you. jumping in the wrong direction, so it's the problem here. All right. I don't know why I can't label my screen this time. Can I? Bye-bye. Oh, I can't. Okay. Alright. Let's do this one last time. Yep. Alright. Limit. One. Two. Deliver. All right. You know what? Let's just grab that from the beginning. So that's there. Copy from 0 to 1. So I've got the two of these. And I want to add them together. No, I don't want to do that yet. I just want to outbox it. Copy from two again. And outbox it. That's my one and one. Okay. So now, if I'm negative, I want to come back here. If I'm not negative, then I want to copy from deliver. And outbox. And go back to the beginning. Okay. Cool. So everything else has to fit in here. So. Oh. Stupid. Copy from 9. Bump it. Copy that to 2. Alright, let's see where we're at right now. Alright. So, got one and one in there. So now, I want to copy from here. I'm going to add it to 2. Want to copy it. I want to copy it to delivery, and then I want to subtract it from limit. If it's not negative, then I just want to jump back to the beginning. There's nothing else to do because I've already delivered what I need to deliver. Okay. If it's negative, go back up here. No, sublimit. If it's negative, if It's negative when I jump over that. Yes. Okay. So if it's positive, go back to the beginning. I'm done. If it's negative, I want to copy from delivery. I want to outbox that. By the way, I'm going to need another jump here that's going to go back to the beginning as well. Alright, I'm going to outbox that. So now, I want to this jump is just jumping over here. Alright, there's negative. Boop. Outbox it. Copy from two. And one. Copy to one. Copy to deliver. Sub limit, then do another jump of negative two over here, copy from deliver a box, and now jump to here, I believe. Alright, I think I've got it now. Alright, I think I did it. Certainly, almost certainly not the most efficient way, but I did it. No. Rep. Where did I screw up? Jump if negative. I guess I should have a jump if zero. Okay, so jump if zero, it's the same spot. Jump if zero, it's the same spot. I got 21 again, so this should tell me if I did the right thing. Hooray! Finally finished! Woo! I knew I wasn't doing that the most efficient. Ooh, nice! I got the speed challenge though! Yes! Nice. Alright. The littlest number. To reduce our carbon footprint, management's requesting the smallest numbers only. It's a public relations exercise. The results are going straight to the landfill. For each zero terminated string in the inbox, send to the outbox only the smallest number you've seen in that string. You'll never be given an empty string. Reset, repeat for each string. Alright. So, grab something. Copy to here, grab something, copy to here, okay, the smallest number. If I take this one minus this one, and it's negative. Then I want to grab this one. Otherwise, I want to grab this one. And jump here. Okay. I'm going to call this one smallest. Maybe I'll do it this way. So that's the smallest. Okay, so copy whatever you get to here. That's my current smallest. Grab the next thing. Put it in. Excuse me. Zero. Subtract it from here. Oh, grab the next thing. If zero. Go here. If it's zero, copy from here. And I'll box it. And jump right to the beginning. Not zero. All right, if it's negative, copy from here, copy to here. Otherwise, copy from here. No. Otherwise, just doesn't matter. You're fine in the right spot. Okay. Might have it already. Let's see. 8 minus 12. I think I'm skipping a jump somewhere. Wait, what? Why are my subs not happening? Oh, okay. Maybe that's why. Nope. I should have inbox zero. No. Whoops. Here? No. Shoot, I screwed up somewhere. So I've got my first thing, my second thing. Alright, hold on. Six. 11. Oh, my subtraction went away some for some reason. Things got screwed up already. Copy to zero, copy to one. Sub zero. Wow, can't believe things got screwed up already. Alright, let's try again. You go there. You go there. Alright. Subtract. You. Alright. So I'm taking one, subtracting this one. This is the smallest one. So this is this one and this one. So let's subtract this number. If I subtract that one from this one, and it's negative, then I want to grab yourself and copy yourself here. If it's not negative, then I want to copy from here to here. So far, so good. You will never be given an empty string. So I think that means I'm going to have at least two. So grab the next one. If zero, copy from here. Outbox it, jump back to the beginning. If it's not zero, then copy to here. Smallest one. Four. So now I'm subtracting this from it. If it's a negative, it's negative, copy from here to here. It's not negative, jump back to here. Okay, I think I got it. We'll see. Four. 15. It's 11, so 4 is the smallest. Wait, what? No. Wait, what happened there? So 4 is the smallest. Ah, I see. I need a jump here that skips that stuff. 3, 12. That's positive, so 3 is the right one. Got 1. Put it there. It's negative, so 1 goes to the up box. Nope. Okay, so I should be also checking here if it's a 0. It's a 0. Go back to the beginning. Goes there. No. They expected 4. Okay, let's go back. So I should at 20 I should do a jump to here, I guess. All right, I did it. Woohoo! Nope. Nope. All right. Time for mod module. How many hours of work can you fit in one day? Not enough. There's always a sad remainder of unworked hours. Good thing we have these optional night shifts to cram in more. Now it's not to do the modulo. Outbox the remainder of the results you divided the first by the second. You have to actually divide and don't worry about negative numbers for now. So how do you compute modulo? I've used modulo in programming, but I don't know how to actually compute it. I'm gonna have to skip this one because I don't know how to compute remainders like that. What's the purpose of this assignment? I think it's something about calculating the volume beneath staircases. You have to put the intern somewhere. Three, two, one. Okay. Interesting, interesting. The sum of itself plus all numbers until we get to 0. Okay. Alright, so let's see. Grab something from the inbox. Yeah, base here. Hello. Alright. So now we need to know.
It's snowing.
It's snowing, yep. If it's 0. Alright, subtract it from 0. The answer is 0. And actually, what's better is jump to 0 back to itself. Okay, that takes care of that situation. Alright, so got 3. Now we need to add it to itself minus 1. So I think what I need to do is also copy it here. Bump minus that number.
Um
No. Alright, I'm gonna need this eventually, but let's see. Add the two numbers together. To the output. Then subtract one from there. Add it to the output. It's negative, then I want to jump to grab the output, unbox it, and jump back to the beginning. Who knows, maybe I just came up with a simple solution. Let's see. 3, 2, 5, 6. Oops. I should have. Copied it to the output. Six. Jump here, I think. If it's a zero, don't want to jump there, I want to jump here. All right, that wasn't so hard. That was going to be a decisive challenge for sure. Midnight Petroleum. scary.
There's a giant eyeball there.
It's this one. Hmm. Is it cheap?
Yeah.
Where are the bosses?
I don't know.
Did you win?
No, not yet. Alright. I have to figure out how to calculate mod. Let's see. Alright, so you do integer division, then you multiply the result with the divisor, subtract. Not sure how you do that with subtraction, though. Okay, I think I have a thing that might work. All right, so I have to grab something from the inbox. Put it here. Grab some from the inbox. Put it here.
Mm-hmm.
Is
it bedtime?
Mm-hmm.
Is it snowing?
Nope. All right, so. The first number is smaller
Alright, so... copy from here. Subtract this one. If negative, then outbox. And jump. Alright. If it's not negative, then... oh, right, so this should be here like this. There we go. Oh, I think I just did the same thing, right? Okay. So it's not negative. Copy from...
yes.
Copy from here. And... this will be... mod. Copy to here, then subtract, okay, now I want to do a, let's see, I want to subtract I don't think I want to do that. I think. Oop, I'll be right back. right. I think I'm going to have to go. I don't think I can try to figure this out with Stella. But I still got to figure out exactly how to do this arithmetic. So, alright, guys. I'll see you later. This has been Eric playing Human Resource Machine. Bye.